talk.
Oh, I have to think about this. Ashley, thanks for letting me be a part of your wedding. Congratulations. Hope you have a good marriage.
Okay, Ashley, we're here for the rehearsal. We're so excited. Carrie, thank you for letting us be a part of your wedding. It's a beautiful church and a beautiful day. I hope it's this pretty tomorrow. We thought we'd video the rehearsal for you so you could have it. I think that'd be really fun.
Hey.
Will all of you witnessing Ashley and Carrie's promises do all in your power to uphold these two
simply will introduce that by saying, let us be attentive to a reading from God's Word. Joe, at that point, I turn to you, so now that I'm here to you with another collection, make eye contact, ask your right hand, step forward a little bit to your left, and here I am, and so just use my hand and put your daughter's hand in mine. Then you'll join your bride there. Carrie, you step in last, and I will immediately give you Asher's hand. At that point in time, I will turn with my two acolytes. We can go up to the altar, and Mr. Smith will play music that's been selected for that. Paige, you and Kittery, the rest of you will listen to me very carefully because we want to do this as much as we'll play. When Kittery and Ashley come up the steps, when they clear the white, I want Carrie to step out and offer Paige your arm just as your son has offered Ashley's hand. But wait until they make the clearing. Don't y'all just stay right there. When they step up, step and go right here. And what we'll do, the first actually would be number 9.
Ashley looks lots better up. They were too bunched up along the choir pews there.
Kooky, or is that what I'm so pretty?
congregation, be seated, please. I know we're a little bit tight, but let's try to keep it at an angle along. Gentlemen, you should be able to look over the left shoulder and the direction that we're looking. So just remember that. And as she comes in, we're here. Guglielmos. I require and charge both. Ashley, will you? Kerry, will you? Will all of you witnessing Ashley and Kerry's promises do all in your power to uphold these two persons in their marriage?
Will.
With grateful hearts, we pray. Amen. Let us be attentive to a reading from God's Word, a reading from John, the Word of the Lord, thanks be to God. A reading from Corinthians, the Word of the Lord, thanks be to God. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Shelby and Hannah, tell Ashley thank you.
Okay. Let's open them in the car.
Hannah.
You're welcome.
Hannah.
Kerry, very graciously introduced me to my sister a few minutes ago. The only part is I forgot my age. I'm also known as Steve Martin, father of the bride. I hadn't seen it, but I had a lot of my friends tell me about it. I feel kind of like it. I want to also welcome all of Ashley's friends and Kerry's friends and relatives. Thank y'all so much.
I'm excited.
With Ashley being the oldest grandchild, she has always had a very special relationship with you, Bob. You have always been a willing participant, contributor to whatever she might have up her sleeve. You have been a lot to her, and we thank you for that. There are a couple other family members, and I'm going to walk over here, and these are Ashley's godparents, three godparents plus Robert. My sister and her husband, Joe Claire and Henry, and Susu's sister, Patty, and plus Robert. And y'all have meant a lot to Ashley as she is growing up. And Sus and I want to especially thank y'all for everything y'all have done for her over the years. Sus and I have often said that Ashley was more like Patty and Joe Claire than she was Susan. The phrase I've always used with Ashley as she was growing up, you have champagne taste on a beer budget. She gets the champagne taste from Joe Claire and Patty and the beard buddy from me. But again, we appreciate all of y'all being here and sharing this night with us. And thank y'all so much. Betsy and Kerry, it's been fun. Sis and I have really enjoyed getting to know y'all and your lovely family over the last 11 months. We visited them last November, met them for the first time, and felt quite at home from the very start. I knew we were invited by Ashley and Kerry, or encouraged by them last summer, to pick a football game on a weekend that we could go to Baton Rouge and meet them. Well, knowing Ashley, I knew she had something up her sleeve. I didn't realize that that was leading to where we are tonight, but here we are. But the only unfortunate thing about that weekend is that they gave me a choice of games, and I picked the Alabama game last year to go to.
Missed
it. I'm glad I didn't come to that Ole Miss game last weekend. You'd probably never invite me back. But it's been fun. I really feel one of the nice things is I feel like when all this is over with, my sister and I have acquired two new good friends. It has really been enjoyable. I'm going to kind of miss all the faxes that we've done back and forth over the last several months. But the good thing about it is I finally learned how to spell Guglielmos. Also, let me say that Susan and I are so excited to have Kerry as our son-in-law. He is exactly what Susan and I had hoped Ashley would find in Tulsa. You know, knowing Ashley, you know it had to be somebody really special, and Kerry is that person. Ashley, we know how much you mean to your mother. We hope this weekend turns out like you always hoped it would be since you were a very little girl, down to every little detail. You know your mother and I have always been there for you. Nothing changes. We'll still be there for you, but we'll now be there for you and Kerry. Kerry, your life is getting ready to get real important. No more Nike boxes in the floor. No more Nike posters on the wall. No more dirty dishes in the sink. Your house is getting ready to get really clean. A little advice for you. If she cuts those eyes at you, you're in trouble. When she comes back from a shopping spree, and you ask her, Ashley, what did you buy? And she answers, oh, I'm just looking at something. Her upper lip is quivering. You know she's lost. Your social calendar is now full. No more rest periods on the weekend. No more laying around watching football games. No more watching golf tournaments. You're going to be on the go. But let me tell you, somebody that's been there, when the day's over, the function or the event is over, you're going to look back and say, that Ashley is something. It was a lot of fun. I have a little symbol here that I want to give to you. I'll pull it out of my pocket. I'll kind of lipstick and everything else. This is a little string. It came off one of y'all's wedding gifts. Ashley's had me tied around her little finger all her life. I'm going to pass this string on to you. I want you to hold on to it and keep it.
What I wanted to talk to you about for just a minute was some tradition, and as I'm share with this group some of the things that almost overcome me here tonight. First, Carrie, we really enjoy getting to know you in Houston. And you and I have a lot in common. We both came to Shreveport and married Jones girls who had graduated from SMU and who were the apples of their father's eye and had expensive tastes. All I can tell you is based on many, many years of experience, to make wonderful wives. You're fortunate indeed. Now, I also think that you'll very much enjoy being a part of the Jones family. I've been blessed with one of the greatest brother-in-laws anyone could possibly have, and Susu has been a wonderful part. It's been a great experience. I know you're going to enjoy that. But I want to share with you some of the tradition and end with a toast, because this, you know, the old Yogi Berra expression is a case of deja vu all over again. Let me share with you that many, many years ago, Joe Claire and I had our rehearsal dinner in this very club, and we were married in St. Mark's Church. Some years later, unfortunately, Scotty's father, Jody, had passed away. I was honored to be his best man, and the rehearsal dinner was here. Coming back tonight makes me realize how well that works in this family. There's more than 60 years of past marriage involved in marriages that have followed from rehearsal dinners here. And so what I want to do is end with a toast and say that I hope your marriage will be at least as happy and long and prolific as those who have been through this same rehearsal dinner process to join the family.
Hear, hear.
John Harmon came down to this. We talked about this a lot, and I've been lucky at my young age. I've been able to travel around a little bit and meet some different people. And we've talked often that the different people we've met, and it really truly amazes me the connection that we seem to all have as friends. And you know, I'm almost 30 years old now, and we still continue to talk on just a weekly basis, whether that's with John Harmon or someone like Chris Myers, who I met recently, or one of my best friends, David Strange. Who's in Phoenix, Arizona, Hal Seward, who comes from Jacksonville, Florida, and it really, really means a lot to me. It's an issue of loyalty, and it's something that is truly dear to me. So I thank everybody for coming, because it's not an easy place. We love Shreveport, but really, thank everyone for their efforts for coming and making this a special weekend. I'd like to talk, other than Ashton, I'll touch in a second, but really three real special ladies in my life. And first of all, I'd like to talk about my two sisters. The world with me, I have an older sister who's been somewhat vicious and good guidance. Really meant a lot to me, and you know how much I love you. Doris, right there. Your family and obviously Patrick and Benson kids, I know it's brought a great joy to my family, including me and Ashley, which means a lot to us. And then lastly, there were some references previously to my mother, and I have to say that those things are true, and first of all, I'd like to just thank my mom for all the effort that she's put in. I mean, you can't imagine what she's done the last 10 months. All of her efforts for this wonderful occasion, so everyone can enjoy themselves this weekend. And then I'd like to talk about a few men in my life. First of all, I'd like to recognize my grandfather, who's over at this table here. He's 88 years old. And, give away your age, but I figured you he's still fighting tigers as much as ever at 88, so you've obviously been a stallion in the family, and we appreciate everything. I guess the next person I'd like to talk about is my uncle, and he's been a big influence in my career, and he means a lot to me. He's more than, feels a lot closer. I'm judging maybe too late for him to admit that now, but I'd like to acknowledge him and give some appreciation for everything that he's done for our family and me. The last person I'd like to speak about is my father, and Ashley and I have talked about this before. I mean this at the bottom of my heart. I've told Ashley that Dad has always been a hero to me, and I can be half the man that you are from an ethical standpoint, a family man, a father, a husband, and I know I'll be successful. So I just want to thank you for everything that you've done for me, and Ellie, and Doris, and Angela. Thank you for this whole week. And I'm getting pretty close here, and I'd like to also very much thank the Joneses. They've made me feel very comfortable, and they've just been super. Sincere, I can't thank you enough for what you've done for us. Jody, Scotty, it's just enough to put these crazy things. But we really do appreciate it. We appreciate you having us. And you appreciate it very much. And lastly, and most importantly, she is the most special person to me here tonight. That's my future wife, is Ashley. And I'm going to steal kind of a one line from a movie I saw recently, but I think it's true. We all know Ashley is very beautiful physically, but the most important to me is how beautiful the girl inside is important to me. And the one thing that I can say is that she truly, truly does complete me.
Today is your day. Okay.
Great party. Great wedding. Where's Shelby?
And the only sister that they have to.
Thank you.
dressed for the occasion. That's darling.
Antique car museum. You can go.
Thad Taylor.
Look here. See the Shelby Mustang?
I know, but I'm reading about it.
Mommy, that's it.
Right. Come stand by it. Let me take your picture. Maybe one day your daddy will get you one.
No way.
Do you love that Dalmatian?
Well, I can't eat both. So where did you go? After you go HOT, then which one did you go to? GOA?
So good, honey. Thanks for going down the aisle. Shelby?
Shelby.
Dad, you look very handsome.
Shelby, come here, honey.
Beautiful.
You did good. That was a long way, and you did good.
Could you see?
They are very much.
Come on.
Ye.
You might get a lucky one.
Hey.
Thank you.
country song.
Who do you think you are?
Oh,
come home.
They don't do that to you.
Now do the deltas. Deltas. Somebody do the triangle. Yeah,
and Billy's eating. Why aren't you in the picture?
And Billy!
Hold on.
And Billy!
Play Daddy out here. We don't either. Daddy, come get the picture.
Okay, y'all look.
Shop on it.
Jody?
Thank you. It's useless to say.
They're coming. Two.
Yes, the battery's running out. I'm just going to let you step on that.
Mother of the bride.
You want it back.
This is what we're going to have. Not bird seed. Have you seen them when they have bird seed?